Our Father and our God, in the name of Jesus Christ, we just come before you with thanksgiving in our hearts. We bless you, for there is no God like you. There is no one like you, Jehovah God. You gave your only begotten Son that we should have everlasting life. This was such great love that you gave your Son to die on the cross for our sins. And here we are, cleansed and washed by the precious blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. We come to you, Jehovah God, Father, with nothing much to give, Jehovah God, except, Jehovah God, to reciprocate the love that you gave unto us, O Lord, the love that you showed unto us, O Lord, by giving the praises, the glory, the honor, and the adoration to you. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ that, Lord, we'll give ourselves wholly to you, Jehovah God, and that we'll dedicate everything that we have and everything that we are to you, O Lord, that, Father, you may use it for the glory, honor, and praise of your name. We thank you for such wonderful love and such wonderful gift that you gave unto us, O Lord. And we pray in the name of Jesus Christ that we will not take this for granted. We surrender this service to your able hands, and we pray that, Lord, you speak unto us, even in ways that we'll be able to understand and to know what, Lord, you are directing us to do. We commit each one of us to you, O Lord, and we look up unto you, Jehovah God, even for the entire service. We pray that every part of this service shall be given unto you, O Lord, and that, Father, you alone shall receive the glory, the honor, and the praise, because you are God, and you deserve the glory, you and you alone, O Lord. We commit us to you, O Lord, and we look up unto you, that you may take us through, Jehovah God. Strengthen us, O Father, for those who are weak, Jehovah God. Lift us up, O Jehovah God, for those who are heartbroken, Jehovah God. We pray that you will have your way in each one of us, O Father, and that at the end of it all, Jehovah God, the glory, honor, and praise shall come back to you. In Jesus' name we pray.
And today we have come, when we meet together as believers, it is the same as being gathered on Mount Zion. And what used to happen there is that it was a place of worship. It was a place where believers will just come and trumpets will be blown, and they will lift up their voices exalting the Lord. And today scripture tells us here, but you have come to Mount Zion, the city of the living God. That is where we are today. And the Bible also says, on the mountain of the Lord there shall be deliverance. Today we are gathered in His presence, and I want us just to go take a moment. Let's worship Him. Let's worship Him. We are gathered in His presence. We are gathered to enthrone Him. We are gathered to exalt Him. We are gathered so that He alone might be glorified. He alone might be seen in our lives. That His power will be revealed in our days. Yes, Lord, we have come to You. We have come to You, the I am that I am. We have come to You, King of glory. Lord, today we are gathered in Your presence to exalt You. We are gathered before the Judge of all. We are gathered before the King of kings. We are gathered before the Lord who compares to no other God. And today, this morning, we'll lift up our worship to You. Because, Lord, on the mountain of the Lord there shall be deliverance. On Your mountain we experience Your power. On Your mountain, oh God, we see You at work. And this morning You're all we want to experience. You're the one we hunger for, oh God. You're the one we have come to worship. We have come to bow down to the God who compares to no other God. We have come to bow down to the God who is almighty. We have come to bow down to the God who supplies our needs according to His riches in glory. And this morning, Lord, we bow down in adoration. We bow down acknowledging that You alone are God. You alone are worthy. You alone, King of all glory. Wewe peke unastahili. Asubu ya leo tunakuabudu. Tunaliinua jina lako. Wewe peke Bwana. Wewe peke unastahili. Ibada yetu, as that song says, oh God, You are all that matters. You are all that matters. This morning we acknowledge, oh God, we put You in front of everything, oh God. We put You in front, oh God, because You are all that matters. You are all, King of glory, that matters. We lay down our crowns, oh God. We lay down every idol, and we acknowledge You as God. you this morning. Yes, Lord Jesus, we worship you. We worship you. We worship you, Jehovah. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, King of glory. Lord, in your presence, oh God, Lord, we are refreshed. In your presence, King of glory, we are healed. In your presence, we are delivered. In your presence, oh God, we encounter, oh God, you. We encounter your might, oh God. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. This morning, we pour out our love to you. This morning, we pour out our worship to you. Lord, tunasema hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe, Mungu wetu. Unastahili ibada yetu. Unastahili kuinuliwa. And Lord, we choose to begin with worship. We choose to begin with exalting you. We choose to begin with magnifying your name. We choose to begin with praising you. Regardless of how the week has been, Lord, you deserve our worship. Regardless of what we have gone through, you deserve our worship. Regardless of what is happening, oh God, you deserve our worship. Lord, regardless of the mountains we have faced, you deserve our worship. Regardless of the valleys we've gone through, oh God, you deserve our worship. Lord, we exalt you, we exalt you. We pour out our hearts to you, King of glory, because there is none like you. You alone are God, you alone are God. Yes, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord Jesus. Receive our worship this morning. Receive our worship this morning. Oh God, what a great God. What a mighty God you are. You are exalted above all the idols, oh God. You are exalted above the gods that are made by the hands of men. Who can compare to you, oh God? Who does mighty things? Who does extraordinary things? We worship you, we worship you. We worship you, we worship you. You, Jesus. We worship you, we worship you, oh God. You are enthroned, oh God. Yes, Lord. We honor you this morning. We enthrone you. You deserve our worship. You deserve our worship. You alone, King of glory, are exalted in this place. Oh, Jesus, oh, Jesus. Lord, we thank you because where two or three are gathered in your name, you are there. And this morning you are here. This morning you are here. Holy Spirit of God, you are among us. You are among us. You are among us. What a joy, what a joy, what an honor, what a privilege, oh God. Lord, that you are among us this morning. You are among us to move in a mighty way. You are among us to do great and mighty things. We adore you, 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 our God. We adore you, our God. Mashetara baba bozai. Oh, we adore you, King of kings, Lord of lords. Mashatala baba bozika tarababo. We adore you, we exalt you. Unastahili sifa bwana. Unastahili ibada yetu mfalme. Unastahili hakuna kama wewe. Wewe pekee bwana. Umeinuliwa mahali hapa. Tunasema ni asante kwa sababu uwepo wako uko hapa. Asante kwa sababu nguvu zako ziko hapa. Asante Bwana, tunakuinua Mungu mkuu. Tunakuinua mfalme wa wafalme. Tunakuinua Bwana wa mabwana. Hakuna kama wewe, hakuna kama wewe. We adore you, we adore you, Jesus. Adore you. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. You You are worthy, you are worthy, oh God. You are worthy, Master. Mandele katarababos. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh, shatalababozikata. We worship you. Oh, we worship you. Mandele karibabozikata. We adore you, we adore you, we adore you. We adore you, our God, we adore you. Oh, rikatalababoze karababoza. We thank you, we thank you for your presence. Oh, thank you, oh God, you are among us in a mighty way, in a glorious way this morning. Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, thank you for your presence, Mashika. Yes, Lord. Mandolo Jose Katara Bush. Yes, Lord Jesus. Yes, Lord. Lord Jesus, yes, Lord, we worship you. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, Mashandu Buza. And Lord,
oh, you are all that matters.
Ordinary Sunday, Lord, just as you told your people, Lord, in the book of Joshua, consecrate yourselves. For tomorrow I will do wonders among you. Lord, we pray that you consecrate us. Lord, we desire that your miracles will be evident in this service. In the name of Jesus, remove every barriers. Remove anything that can hinder your glory. Anything that can hinder you from moving in our lives, we pray that, Lord, you remove it in the name of Jesus. And Father, we pray that you sanctify us. If it is sin, oh God, we repent. We pray that you forgive us, that you cleanse us, oh God. That today, oh God, you will be pleased to do mighty things among us. You will be pleased to heal the sick. You will be pleased to deliver the bound. You will be pleased, oh God, to encourage those who are downcast, oh God. You will be pleased to do miracles, signs, and wonders among us, oh God. Because wherever you went, you did good. Wherever you went, you healed, you delivered, oh God. You opened doors. We pray that today, those who have come in this service trusting you for a miracle, may they meet the miracle worker. May they meet the way maker. May they meet the destiny changer. May they meet the God who heals. May they meet the God who, oh God, who opens doors that no man can open. So Lord, we wait on you. We wait on you this morning. We wait on you this morning. We wait on you, oh God, even through the music. Would you do miracles, signs, and wonders through the preaching, Jehovah God? May it come forth with power in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord, in this service, oh God, something supernatural will happen. Lord, there will be a shift in the atmosphere in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we worship you. We worship you, oh God. We worship you, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. How many believe that the great physician is here? How many of you believe that the great physician is here? Tabibu wa ajabu. And this is a song that gives me a lot of meditation, because what we proclaim with our tongues as we praise the Lord is what happens in the physical. So as you sing this song, believe that the Lord is going to heal you. The Lord is going to save those who are not born again. And those who are expecting healing of the soul, the mind, and the body, you are going to experience it, because the great physician is here.
Bye.
God. Nimesema living God, ndio? So hajakufa ako hai. Hallelujah. Yes, this is better. Sasa tumeimba tabibu, inamaanisha ametutibu. Tumeomba, tukatubu, so tuko light, ndio? We can
naweza tingika kidogo. So si utafute space. Space tu naweza kibililia huyu Yesu, naweza mdanzia huyu Yesu sababu ni tabibu, ametutibu. Tumeomba ametusamehe. So sisi ni watoto sasa wachanga kabisa. We have no sin. Tumetubu. So we are fresh kabisa. Praise God.
Baby.
milele milele nitakuimbia. Ho ho! Ni wewe.
Wewe ndiwe baba yangu.
Sana wangu.
Sana wangu wa karibu.
Yesu ni wewe.
Wewe ndiwe baba yangu.
Sana
wangu wa karibu. Wewe ndiwe
kidogo. Sorry for that.
Sifa
Bwana wa mabwana, pewe sifa, amen.
atatenda mema.
Atatenda mema.
Atatenda mema.
Atatenda mema.
Atatenda mema.
Atatenda mema.
Atatenda
mema.
Atatenda mema.
Atatenda mema.
Atatenda mema.
Atatenda mema. Atatenda mema. Atatenda mema. Washangilia Bwana Yesu.
Shangwe, haleluya, shangwe kwa Yesu, haleluya.
Shangwe, haleluya, shangwe kwa Yesu, haleluya.
Haleluya, shangwe kwa Yesu, haleluya.
Shangwe, haleluya, shangwe kwa Yesu, haleluya.
Shangwe, haleluya, shangwe kwa Yesu.
Shangwe, haleluya, shangwe kwa Yesu, haleluya.
Kwa Yesu,
haleluya.
Yesu,
haleluya.
Yesu,
haleluya.
Shangwe,
shangwe, haleluya,
shangwe kwa Yesu,
haleluya.
Kwa Yesu,
haleluya.
Shangwe kwa Yesu,
haleluya.
Shangwe kwa Yesu,
haleluya.
Shangwe kwa Yesu,
haleluya.
Shangwe kwa Yesu,
haleluya.
Shangwe, haleluya, shangwe kwa Yesu, haleluya.
Shangwe,
mama mkuu na hizo shangwe,
haleluya.
Shangwe, haleluya, shangwe kwa Yesu, haleluya.
Shangwe, haleluya, shangwe kwa Yesu, haleluya.
Yesu,
hallelujah,
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 hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Kama unapenda Yesu ruka kidogo
kidogo.
Kama unapenda Yesu ruka kidogo
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 kidogo.
Ruka ruka kidogo, ruka ruka ruka
kidogo
kidogo
kidogo.
Kama unapenda Yesu sema hey man,
hey man.
Kama unapenda Yesu sema haleluya,
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 haleluya.
Sifu,
Yesu sifu,
sifu,
Bwana
sifu
sifu
Yesu ni mwokozi wangu ndio naimba
imba
Yesu ni mwokozi wangu ndio naimba
imba
imba imba imba
imba
Amen. Let's give all the glory to God. Let's give a big clap to the Lord. He's a great God. And we're just going to declare how great our God is. He's so great. He saved us. He saved you. He has healed you. He has done so many things that you cannot even count. You have the blessings that God has given unto us, each one of us, are not countable. Even this very morning, being alive is a blessing and is a miracle. So we ought to thank the Lord for many things that he has done to us, many things that we cannot count. How great is our God? Sing with me. How great is our God? And I will see how great, how great.
God because he is greater than anything else. Mungu wetu ni mkuu. Mungu wetu anastahili ibada. Mungu wetu ni Mungu ambaye anastahili kuabudiwa. Hakuna aliye kama wewe. Hakuna aliye kama wewe Mungu wetu. Tunakuabudu Bwana. We worship you Lord. We adore you this morning. We come before you O God with hearts of gratitude. We come before you our Lord with hearts of thanksgiving O God, proclaiming that there is none like you. There is nothing compares to you. This morning our Father called you Psalmist 144. Praise the Lord, my protection. He trains me to battle and prepares me for war. He is my protector and my defender, my shelter and savior, in whom I trust for safety. He subdues the nations under me. That is the word of God. That is the promise of the word of God. He is our protector. The Lord is our savior. We find no refuge right now, nowhere else, but in the Lord who is our savior. Let us uplift the Lord. Let us give all our burdens to the Lord. All burdens are lifted to Calvary. All burdens are lifted to Calvary. This morning, the Lord is here in our midst. His presence is here in this morning. Let us praise the Lord. Let us come before the Lord. Let us come before him in worship. Let us come before him in adoration. He deserves all the honor. He deserves all the praises. Oh, my Father, we adore you this morning. Tunakuabudu Mungu wetu. Unastahili sifa Bwana. Unastahili ibada ya mioyo yetu. Umeahidi ya kwamba wewe ni Mungu wetu. Katika kitabu cha Zaburi 23, unasema ya kwamba the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Thank you, my Father, for your word, because you have lifted your word above your name. And this morning, Lord, we abide by your word. Tunasimama na neno lako Bwana. Tunasimama na maandiko yako Masia. Haijalishi Mungu wetu yale yanayotuzunguka kwa wakati huu. Haijalishi Bwana wetu yale tunayopitia wakati kama huu. Tunajua Mungu wetu ni mkuu. Tunajua umeketi katika kiti chako cha enzi. Wewe ni mponyaji wetu. Wewe ni mponyaji wa nafsi zetu. Wewe ni mponyaji wa jamii zetu. Wewe ni mponyaji wa maisha yetu. Hatutasingizika Mungu wetu. Thank you my Father this morning. Thank you dear Lord my Father. Help us to keep your word in our hearts, that we will not sin against you my Father. Help us to stand still King of Glory. The psalmist says that I pray early in the morning and I sit back as I wait my God to reply, as I sit my God to come through. Yes my Father, we stand before you as your children. Dear Lord, we commit our supplication before you Lord with thanksgiving oh God and gratitude in our heart this morning. Lord, we do not doubt your presence. We do not doubt the things that you are able to do King of Glory. My Father, we have tasted of your kindness, we have tasted of your faithfulness, and we know that God you are faithful. We know that Lord you are loving. You know, we know that Father you are able to heal our diseases. We know that Lord you are able to deliver. And this morning, dear God, we lift our voices to you. We lift our hands before you, King Almighty. We have no other God but you alone. We have no other king but you alone. Our Father, we do not bow before idols, but we bow before Almighty God, who is able to deliver us, who is able to give us a true joy, who is able to give us a true peace. We find peace in you, God. And this morning we raise our voices to you. This morning we lift our bodies to you, King of Glory. My Father and my God, this morning you are God here, oh God, and your presence is in our midst. Because your word says, King Almighty, where two or three are gathered in your name, my Father, you are in the midst. And dear Lord, we have fell down of your presence. Lord, move in our midst, oh God. Heal the diseases amongst us, oh God. Deliver the bodies amongst us, oh God. Heal your people, King Might of Glory, because your presence is healing. Your presence is heaven to us. Your presence is heaven to your people, King Might of Glory.
Come unto, dear Lord, what no man can do. Come unto the things that no one can do, my Father. Yes, dear Lord, as parents and children, we lift them to you. We surrender them to your King Almighty. We surrender them to you, our Father. You are the teacher and the protector. Oh, King of glory, would you set them apart, oh, my Father? Would you come and wipe the tears of your people, my Father? Because, dear Lord, your word says, you shall keep, you shall bless the fruit of our wombs. Lord, you didn't say that you give us pain, but you gave us blessings. We look at our children, dear Lord, and we speak blessings, King of glory. My Father, we adore you and we bless you because of them. Oh, my Father, none of us is going to cry because of the blessing that you are giving us, oh Lord. You are delivering this morning. You are delivering this morning. You are restoring this morning, my Father. You are restoring this morning, King Might of Glory. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, dear Lord. Thank you, my Father. You hear the prayers of your saints and you answer. You hear the prayers of your people and you answer by fire. You hear the prayers of your saints and you answer, oh God, by fire. Oh, thank you, my Father. Thank you, dear Lord. We receive your blessings this morning. We receive your blessings in humility this morning. We receive your blessings this morning. Yes, Lord, you did it yesterday. You have done it today, oh God. You shall do it tomorrow, my Father. Because we believe and trust in God Almighty, a living God. Nothing is above you, God. Nothing compares to your King of glory. This morning we adore you. We adore you, Lord. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, dear Lord. As a church, Lord, we commit this month to you. A month of renewal. A month of mission, King of glory. Oh Lord, what can we tell your people unless you send us? What can we take to the world unless you send us? Lord, would you send us? Would you send us, oh King of glory? Would you send your people? Lord, we are saying we are available. Send us, oh God, to deliver goodness. Send us, oh King of glory, where your will is, oh God. Yes, my Father, send us and hold our steps, oh God. Yes, touch our lips as you touch Jeremiah. Touch our lips, oh King of glory. Whatever we speak, whatever we say to your people, let it come from you, Holy Spirit of God. Send us, oh King of glory. We are pour ourselves before you. Send us, Almighty God. Your will be done, oh God, in this church. Your will be done in this sanctuary, oh God. No one is lifted above you, Lord. But you alone, King of glory. You are worshipped here, Almighty Father. Have your way. Take your place, God Almighty. Take your place, oh God. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, dear Lord. Thank you, my Father. We remember to pray for our children who have just gone back to school. Lord, we pray that in school, King of glory, you shall make them that light, oh King of glory. That love which is put on top of mountains, oh God. They shall, oh my Father, deliver the light of the world. The light of the Lord. Because Lord, you are protecting them. Lord, you are surrounding them, oh King of glory. Lord, you are setting them apart, oh King of glory. And dear Lord, they shall be different. Something, oh God, shall be noticed in them. Something different shall be noticed. Because you are doing that, God, for your glory. You are doing that, King of glory, for the honor and the whole, my Father, glory of your holy name. Thank you, dear Lord, this morning. We worship you. We worship you. We love you, Lord. You loved us before we loved you, King of glory. You knew us before we were born and you chose us. Thank you, Lord. We are called the tribe of Judah. And dear Lord, we worship you. You created us to worship. And that is why we have come and gathered here, Lord. You alone receive our adoration and all the glory, my Father. We commit our service, the rest of program to you, O God. Lord, have your way. Teach us, O God. Teach us, O God, how to stand and how to come before you and how to do things in your will, O God. Have your way. Take your place, your majesty, O God. Holy is your name, O God. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, my Father. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your presence, our ministers. Yes, Lord. We bless you and we honor you. It is in Jesus' name we pray and trust. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Music team, you can take your seat. Thank you.
much. Good morning, church. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Majina yangu ni Susan Kete. Mimi ndiye kiongozi wa ibada siku ya leo. Yes, I'm today's service leader by the grace of God. I would want to notice any visitor among esters, anyone who has come, who has worshipped with us today for the first time. If anyone, a visitor among esters, please, would you wave at me or maybe you raise your hand? Any visitor today? Any visitor? Wow. Second time visitors, those who have been here and today they have come for their second time. Wave at me. Hakuna. Hakuna. So sisi wote ni wenyeji. Si ndio? Salimia yule ako karibu na wewe. Na si yule mmekuja na yeye. Jackie, salimia mwingine hapo nyuma. Yule mmekuja na yeye mmesalimiana. Mumeangaliana. Angalia mwingine hapo msalimie. Tell them I love you. Tell them I love you. And when someone tells you I love you, tell them I love you back. I love you back. I love you. I love you back. I love you. I love you back. Wow. 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 Tujipigie makofi. Asante. Si unajua, hii asubuhi, ama labda wiki iliyopita, ama mwezi. Maybe there's somebody here who has never been told I love you. Sindio? Eh? Eh? So, we love each other because we are brethren, we are brothers and sisters, and the love is the love of Christ. Amen. It's time for offering. Ushers, to wait on us as we give our offerings. Music team can come in front and have one number.
Haleluya. Hii ni nasiri na Yesu. Tuliimba hapa tena. So tunaimba na nyinyi. So ukitoa sandaka usikae chini. Utatoa na usimame na tuendelee, si ndio? Si kila mtu ako na siri na Yesu.
Yes.
So tukiimba sisi ni mtakuwa mnafanya nini? Si lazima mwambie uko na siri na Yesu. So hata wewe mwambie uko na siri naye.
Siri naye Yesu yanifanya niwe jasiri kwa amani nayo fiki yanifanya niwe jasiri yaniburudisha nikiruka ruka nikimba hosana amen yaniburudisha Hosana ame Nina siri nae
Siri nae Yesu
Siri nae
Yanifanya niwe jasiri
Kwa amani
Kwa amani nayo viki Yanifanya niwe jasiri
Yaniburudisha
Yaniburudisha
Nikiruka ruka
Yaniburudisha Nikiruka ruka Hosana amen
Nina siri naye
Nina siri naye Yesu Yanifanya niwe jasiri
Kwa amani
Kwa amani nayo viki Yanifanya niwe jasiri
Yanib
Hosana amen.
Mimi yani burudisha,
yani burudisha.
Nikiruka
ruka nikiruka. Hosana amen.
Wambie wanaolia wakiteswa na mali wengu, waonjeni neema yake na rehema yake Mwokozi.
Oh, watafunguliwa,
watawekwa huru wakiimba hosana amen. Oh, watafunguliwa, watawekwa huru wakiimba
hosana amen.
Waambie wanaolia,
waambie wanaolia wakiteswa na mali mwengu,
waonje neema yake na rehema yake Mwokozi.
Watafunguliwa,
watawekwa huru
na kufunguliwa
hosana amen.
Watafunguliwa,
watafunguliwa,
watawekwa huru,
watawekwa huru, wataimba hosana amen.
Nina siri na
Yesu, nina siri na Yesu,
na Yesu
nifanya niwe jasiri.
Nina siri na Yesu,
nina siri na Yesu, yanifanya niwe jasiri.
Kwa amani,
kwa amani nayofikiri, yanifanya niwe jasiri.
Yaniburudisha,
yaniburudisha, nikiruka ruka hosana amen.
Yani burudisha,
yani burudisha, ikiruka ruka ikiruka hosana amen.
Yes, we can pray for offerings. The children can be standing as we pray for them to go to their classes and even their teachers. Children, be standing. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, this morning we thank you for this section of giving our offerings and our tithes to you, O God. We have just given a portion of blessings that we have received from you, O God, as a sign of thanksgiving, because you are a provider. And dear Lord, you are our God. We worship you even with our finances. We worship you with our hearts. We worship you with everything around us, for that is your command. Thank you, Lord, for what we have given. Lord, we pray that you may bless. Even it is called, the offering calls, Almighty Father, to do your, to expand your kingdom. Lord, we pray that you may receive it, O God. And bless us, O God. Bless our pockets, bless our jobs, bless our businesses, O God. You is able to rebuke the defaulter. Thank you for the Sunday school children. Even as they go to their classes, Lord, we commit them to you. Lord, would you bless them? Would you open their inner hearts and the inner minds, King of Glory, to understand? Lord, even as they are being told by their teachers, to understand you more, to know you more. And Lord, that you may stir up the thirst in their hearts to know you more, O God. Not just going to Sunday school because it is a normal thing, it is a routine. But Lord, they will be there, O God, and be nurtured in the ways of the Lord. We pray for the teachers. Lord, would you bless them? Would you, King of Glory, mighty Lord, expand and share your mind and your knowledge to them. Even Lord, as you send them forth and go to your vineyard in these young ones and deliver your will to them. Thank you, my Father. Have your way and be glorified even as we continue. In Jesus' name we pray and trust. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Now it's time for Bible reading, and I would want to call Lavrin to come. She'll be reading the English part of it, and then I'll be reading Kiswahili. Thank you for coming, Lavrin.
We are reading the book of Luke chapter 25, Luke chapter 10, verse 25-37. Luke chapter 10,
Our Bible reading comes from the book of Luke, chapter 10, from verse 25-37. The parable of the Good Samaritan. On one occasion, an expert in the law stood up and to test Jesus. "Teacher," he asked, "what must I do to inherit eternal life? What is written in the law?" He replied, "How do you read it?" He answered, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself." "You have answered correctly," Jesus replied. "Do this and you will live." But he wanted to justify himself, so he asked Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" In reply, Jesus said, "A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho when he was attacked by robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came where the man was, and when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wound, pouring oil and wine. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day, he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper. 'Look after him,' he said, and when I return, I will reimburse you for any extra expense you may have. Which of these three do you think was a good neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of robbers?" The expert in the law replied, "The one who had mercy on him." Jesus told him, "Go and do likewise."
Anasoma kwa Kiswahili. Baadaye mwanasheria mmoja alisimama akamuuliza akitaka kumtega, "Mwalimu, nifanye nini ili nipate uhai wa milele?" Yeye akamuuliza, "Imeandikwa nini katika sheria? Unaelewa?" Akamjibu, "Mpende Bwana Mungu wako kwa moyo wako wote, kwa roho yako yote, kwa nguvu zako zote na kwa akili yako yote. Na mpende jirani yako kama unavyojipenda mwenyewe." Yesu akamwambia, "Vema, fanya hivyo nawe utaishi." Lakini yeye alitaka kujihakikishia kuwa mwema, akamuuliza Yesu, "Na jirani yangu ni nani?" Yesu akamjibu, "Mtu mmoja alikuwa anashuka kutoka Yerusalemu kwenda Yeriko. Alipokuwa njiani, alifahamiwa na majambazi. Wakamnyang'anya mali yake na kumpiga. Wakamwacha amelala pale nusu mfu. Kumbe kuhani mmoja hakawa anapita barabarani ile ile, akamwona, akapita kando. Hali kadhalika ya Mlawi mmoja, alipofika mahali hapo akamwona, akapita kando. Lakini Msamaria mmoja aliyekuwa anasafiri alifika pale yule mtu alipokuwa, naye alipomwona alimuonea huruma. Akamwendea, akamjibu, akamtibu majeraha yake kwa kumtia mafuta na divai na kuyafunga. Halafu akampandisha juu ya punda wake, akampeleka katika nyumba moja ya wageni, akamuunguza. Kesho yake akatoa fedha dinari 2 akampa yule mwenye nyumba, akamwambia, "Munguze mtu huyu, na chochote atakachotumia zaidi nitakulipa nitakaporudi." Kisha Yesu akamuuliza, "Kati ya hao watatu ni yupi aliyeonyesha kuwa jirani yake aliye yule aliyefahamiwa na majambazi?" Yesu, yule mwalimu wa sheria akamjibu, "Ni yule aliyemuonea huruma." Yesu akamwambia, "Nenda ufanye vivyo hivyo." Na hilo ndilo neno la Bwana. And now we would want to pray for Pastor Vincent as he brings the word. Heavenly Father, we thank you this moment.
The word says that you have lifted your word above your name. Mungu wetu unapo menga mkate huu na chakula cha uhai kwa ajili ya watoto wako. Tunaomba Bwana ukaandae mioyo yetu. Wanatufunze, tufundishe e Bwana. Yalivyo mapenzi yako siku ya leo ni kwa ajili ya neno lako. Na mkabidhi mtumishi wako mikononi mwako. Bwana mpake mafuta mabichi ni kwa ajili ya neno lako. Bwana, wacha Mungu wa mbinguni mapenzi yako yakaonekane wazi na dhahiri kwa ajili ya siku ya leo. Katika jina la Yesu Kristo tunaomba na kuamini. Amen.
Thank you so much, Susan and Lovelyn. Let's appreciate them. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Praise God. Amen. So before these young men of valor take these fruits, Ronnie ngojeni kidogo. Before these young men of valor take these to the office, allow me to pray for them and also to thank God for these first fruits that someone has brought into the house of the Lord. Let's pray. Father, we are so grateful this morning and thank you, Lord, for this person, for this family that has brought these first fruits, Lord, to your house. And Lord, we pray for your blessings over them. Lord, you tell us in your word that give and it will come back to you in a good measure, pressed down, shaken together and running over. Lord, they have done that. May we do it for them, O Lord. And that farm, that business, that venture that has brought all these fruits, Lord, may you increase their produce in Jesus' name. And also we commit these fruits to you, that, Lord, they will be used in your house for your glory alone, to feed those who need, those who are in need, O God. And Father, they will also be used, O God, for ministry, to reach out to all those who do not know you. Father, we thank you and we glorify your name. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you so much. You can go with them. To Pigie Makofi, some of them actually are representing us today at NBC Westlands. The Aroma Tournament begins today. So some of them, like the Angalas, Travis and Rogers, are playing for the NBC Kitengela team. So we are wishing them all the best. Secondly, our renewal week begins on Wednesday. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And we encourage all of us to attend. The time is 6 to 8 p.m. in the evening after work. So we'll provide a bus, we'll provide transport for the NBC Kitengela people. For us to know you are coming, please register at the back. There is a table there and our sister Catherine is there. So please register so that we can know how many people need transport and then we can coordinate on the other things. They have arrival time and other things. So please attend. You can also invite your friends. You can also invite your family members for this revival week, for this renewal week. And also thirdly, some of our young men and women led by Pastor Peter and Pastor Boniface traveled to Uganda on Friday evening. They've gone there for a mission at a village called Luero, at a district in Uganda that is called Luero, and in a village named Kirianyonza, ama Chiri, Kirianyonza. Yeah, it's where we were last year, and they've gone there to represent us. They've gone there to spread the gospel, and even as they are in that mission field, whenever we pray, let's remember them. Let's commit them to the Lord, that even when they come back, they'll come back with a good report that they impacted the lives of the young men and women in that Luero village. Sorry for that. And lastly, we have a package for every household here. We have some mboga for every household here. So after the service, as some people register for the renewal week and others interact with each other, let's, a family, the head of your household, either the mom or the dad, can go at the church reception and you'll receive a package for your family. Amen? Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Amen. Enough of the Enough of the announcements. Amen. So our mission emphasis month begin today. And the word has been read to us from the book of Luke, chapter 10, verse 25 to 37. Luka, mlango wa kumi, mstari wa 25, hadi 37. And as I was preparing and reading this passage, it reminded me of my time in primary school. So I studied at a school in Kibra during my formative years. It was Ushirika Children's Center. And our head teacher then, it was a small school, so the head teacher was also teaching. Amen? So our head teacher her name is Janet Mwikali. And he taught us this story through a song. And it was a Kamba song. But unfortunately, I'm not going to sing because I might miss out on some words and that might have different meanings. But it went like this. Mondo o mwene wa umie, Jerusalemu aende tenjeliko, enzi ya nene wa komanie, na? Mamu kwata na mamu kona, na mamu tie avalokete. Amen. Amen. That is what teacher Janet taught us. I think I was in class one then, that time. And it has stuck till now. And even as I prepared this passage to share with us, I also got different lessons from this story. And our topic today is, who is your neighbor? We are seeking to understand, who is your neighbor? Just as that lawyer asked Jesus, who is my neighbor? We ask ourselves this morning, who is my neighbor? Jirani yako ni nani? Let's look at Luke 10, 25 to 37 and see how it answers this question for us. This passage narrates that famous story of the good Samaritan, hadithi ya Msamaria mwema. And I bet all of us in our various stages of life have heard this story. An expert of the law tests Jesus with this question. It was a test. What shall I do to inherit eternal life? What shall I do to inherit eternal life? This lawyer asks this question, asks the right question with a wrong motive. Because it was a test. He was seeking to test Jesus. He was a lawyer. He knew the Mosaic law from start to the end. So he had an idea. But he decided to test Jesus, as the Pharisees and the Sadducees then used to ask Jesus such questions. Huyu mtu alikuwa anajaribu Yesu na swali hili. Akimuuliza, je, nifanye nini ili nipate maisha ya milele? Nifanye nini ili nipate hii uzima wa milele? Jesus responds by telling him to quote what is already written on the law. Jesus does not give him a response that is out of nowhere. Jesus does not give him a new thing. He tells him to quote what is already there. Yesu anamwambia asome na aseme kitu ambacho kilikuwa katika vitabu za hiyo wakati, in the books of law then. And he answered in verse 27, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, and with all your mind. And love your neighbor as yourself. Kwa Kiswahili nasema, yule mwalimu wa sheria akajibu, mpende Bwana Mungu wako kwa moyo wako wote, na kwa nafsi yako yote, kwa nguvu zako zote na kwa akili zako zote. Na umpende jirani yako kama unavyojipenda mwenyewe. This also answers this question to us. How can we inherit eternal life? If we want to inherit this eternal life, then we should love God with all that we are, with our heart, our mind, our soul, and our strength.
And in addition, love his people as ourselves. Love our neighbors as ourselves. And there's that famous song that goes, God loves people more than anything. So God loves people, the people that he created. And because God loves people, he also wants us, you and me, as believers, believers now and believers then, when he was giving this response, to love their neighbors as themselves. The lawyer later asks, who is my neighbor? Jirani yangu ni nani? Who is this person that is supposed to receive love? Who is this person that I'm supposed to love as myself? Those people, the lawyer and the people, then had a wrong understanding of this question. He was just trying to justify himself. Yes, he has been applying this, but he has been applying this law partially. And the deeds of how they have been loving their neighbors. They just want to justify how they've been doing things. So they were cross-referencing with what Jesus was telling them, was responding to them. How watu walikuwa wanataka waonekane wako sawa, ya kwamba wamekuwa wakimpenda Mungu na wamekuwa wakipenda jirani yao. Na ndiposa wakauliza Yesu, jirani yangu ni nani? This law expert figured out that he had been obeying the first commandment to the fullest, but he had a problem with the second one. Now that he has been taught to love God, ameambiwa apende Mungu na kila kitu akonayo, akaamua sasa kufuatilia hii ya pili, about loving your neighbor, kumpenda jirani yako. Maybe the keeping of this second commandment to them depended on his definition of neighbor. The keeping and execution of this commandment, the obeying of this commandment, depended on their definition of who a neighbor was to them. His love for neighbors, their love for neighbors then, was not standard. It varied from person to person. How wakati huo wakipenda jirani yao, hawakuwa na kiwango sawa kwa kila mtu. Ilikuwa inalingana wewe ni nani, umetoka wapi, umetoka kwa familia gani, umefanya nini, ndiposa utaonyesha upendo kulingana na wewe, ili wajue kwanza wewe ni nani, ndiposa uonyesha upendo kulingana na kiwango chako. And often, many times, you and me have been in this situation. You and me have been in this confusion, not knowing who our neighbors are. We can do things to our churchmates, our next door neighbors, but we cannot do things to the people that we meet for the first time, maybe a place away from home. We often follow the first commandment to the latter, to the end. Tunafuata hii ya kwanza, hadi mwisho, tunampenda Mungu na yote tunayo, lakini tunasahau kufuata hii ya pili. The second greatest commandment, loving our neighbors as ourselves. And I want us to see who is our neighbor. Who is your neighbor? A neighbor is anyone around us, regardless of their ethnicity, race, religion, denomination, or even their social economic status. Jirani yetu ni mtu yeyote. Hailingani yeye ni wa kabila gani, nchi gani, rangi gani, kiwango gani ya maisha. Anyone that exists is our neighbor, whether we know them or we do not know them. Iwapo tunawajua hama hatuwajui, tumewahi kuongelesha hama hatujawahi kuongelesha. A neighbor is anyone in need. The needs can vary from spiritual needs to physical needs to emotional needs and even to social needs. Jirani ni mtu yoyote ambaye ako na hitaji. Hitaji ya kiroho, hitaji pia ya hizi vifaa ambavyo tunahitaji kila siku, the physical needs. Everyone around you, everyone around us is our neighbor. From here to our homes, to our workplaces, and even to Kiwa town. Pali ambapo atukuangi kila siku. Jesus narrates the story of the Good Samaritan, where we meet four main characters. We meet the man who was attacked, we meet the priest, we meet the Levite, and we meet the Good Samaritan. As I read this passage, a Swahili proverb came to my mind. Umdhaniae siye, and I rephrased it to umdhaniae ndiye. Let's do it again. Umdhaniae siye, na umdhaniae ndiye. Very nice, we are on the same page. We all expected from this story, the priest and the Levite to offer help to that man. These people were church workers. That was their job. I can just imagine, apart from preaching on the synagogue and apart from working on the synagogue, they also offered other services like counseling, like helping those people in need. Maybe the sacrifices and the offerings that were brought into the temple. They used to give the people in need food and these other things. They used to maybe to help those who are sick, maybe with hospital costs or with medication or with prayers and all that. But this time, the priest was going to Jerusalem, where the temple was. Maybe he was going for their renewal week. He was late. Maybe he was going for the service. He was the one preaching or leading the service. Maybe he was in a rush. And so once he saw that man, wakati aliona huyo mtu ambaye alipigwa na wezi amelala hapo, vitu vingi vilikuwa kwa akili yake. Nisaidie huyo mtu, nichelewe pali naenda, ama tu niende na nimuombe nikiendelea kutembea. The same to the Levite. Alipita akaona huyu mtu hapa, and they did nothing. Hawakufanya kitu chochote. Walipita mbali na kuelekea zao. This is not recorded anywhere. But maybe they thought to themselves, the priest and the Levite, every man for himself, God, every man for himself, God for us all. Maybe they thought that as they were passing by. It's not recorded in the scripture, but maybe. Just trying to read their thoughts. And this is how sometimes we think as believers. We know someone in need. We know a neighbor in need. We see an existing need in our community, an existing need around us, and we can do something about it. Even if it is not much, we can do something about it. But we end up not doing anything. What do we do instead? We pass by. We pass by and we justify ourselves with statements like, "Atakuwa poa. All things will be well on their side. I will pray for him," and we will not pray. "I will call him tomorrow," and you fail to call. "I will follow up," and you fail to do anything. Wakati mwingi sisi wa Kristo tunakuwa kama huyu kuhani au makuhani ambao walipita mbali na huyo mtu, na tunakosa kusaidia wale ambao wanahitaji usaidizi wetu. The priest and the Levite, as I've said, are a good example of how we believers are. We are diligent in doing the things of God, serving in his house, participating in all church events and activities, loving God with all our hearts, souls, minds, and strength. But expressing love to our neighbors is where we draw the line, is where our struggle is. We meet the third person, a Samaritan, Msamaria. Alikuwa anapita tu kama hao makuhani. Kisha akaona huyu mtu hapo amelala. Ameumia. The Samaritan was passing by, and he saw this person who is in need. And what are we seeing in that scripture? We are told that he had compassion on him. The Samaritan, his first reaction is that he had compassion on this man that is in need. And maybe the environment there wasn't that safe because there were thieves. Maybe hiyo njia ya kuenda Jerusalem haikuwa na street lights. Haikuwa na watu wengi, ndiposa wezi walikuwa wanajificha hapo na wanafumania watu na kuwaibia. But this Samaritan risked his life to stop. He risked his all to stop. He had a donkey. So probably on that donkey he had other valuables because he was traveling. Huyu Msamaria aliamua kusimama ili kusaidia huyu ambaye alikuwa anahitaji usaidizi. He had compassion on him, meaning he had pity, alimuonea huruma, and he had sympathy on that man. The Samaritan's compassion, heartfelt compassion, heartfelt mercy, that pity led him to act, led him to do something because of what he felt in his heart. The Samaritan, huyu Msamaria, alikatiza safari yake. He canceled his trip. He went to the man. He dressed his wounds. He poured oil and wine on him. He took him to an inn or a hotel. Alimpeleka hotelini. Na pia akamuosha na akamsaidia kuosha hizo vidonda. In this case, the wine was used as an antiseptic. The same way now we use hydrogen peroxide. So it was used as an antiseptic for the wounds. And the oil was used to smear on the wound to reduce the pain on the man's body. So the Samaritan sacrificed. The Samaritan took care of the man till the next day. Huyu Msamaria aliamua kuangalia huyu mtu ambaye alikuwa amefumaniwa. Akamfanyia hivyo vitu vyote hadi siku iliyofuata. Kwa hivyo alipoenda hotelini aliamua kukaa na yeye. Maybe the man was unconscious. Maybe huyu mtu alikuwa amepoteza fahamu, akaamua kukaa na yeye hadi siku iliyofuata. He paid for the hotel and was ready to cover any other extra charges that might be incurred by the hotel as they took care of the man. Of that injured man. What an act of love. Love in action. He gave 2 denarii to the hotel. And these 2 denarii are translated to be 2 days' wages. So suppose you are a casual or I'm a casual. And my daily wages is 1,000 bob per day or 1,500 per day or 500 shillings per day. And I work from 6 to 6. Nafanya kazi siku nzima na nimepewa hii 1,000 ya siku moja. Na siku ingine nikaongezewa 1,000 ingine moja. Alafu nipate mtu ambaye akona hitaji. Na natumia mshahara yangu ya siku 2 kwa mahitaji yake. That is what this man did. He gave an amount that is equated to 2 days' wages, the 2 denarii. Just imagine that. This is love in action. The Samaritan did all these kind actions to a man who is not his family or a friend or anyone he knew. He did this to a neighbor. He did this because he understood the second greatest commandment. That love your neighbor as yourself. Maybe as he was walking, he found this man lying there unconscious and beaten up. And he thought to himself, what if it was me? What if it was me? Je, ingekuwa mimi. Na mtu apite na niache hapa, nitasikiaje. So he did to that man what he can do to himself. What he wishes to be done to himself. This parable is a good one. Another preacher said, parables are mirrors and windows. Mafumbo ni dirisha na vio. It is a mirror because we see ourselves in them. Parables are mirrors because we see ourselves in them. Mafumbo ni vio kwa sababu tunajiona kupitia mafumbo hayo. Na ni dirisha kwa sababu tunasoma kupitia hizo. They are windows because we learn from others. We learn through these parables. We have seen ourselves in this mirror. Many times we have become like the priest and the Levite. Tumekuwa kama hawa makuhani na hawa wafanyakazi wa hekalu. We have passed by situations or people that needed our help, but we didn't do anything. Instead, we justified our inaction. We didn't do anything. We have given many excuses to justify our ignorance and our unkindness. Many times, me included, we have failed. We have become like the priests and the Levites. We have failed to show love to our neighbors, all because we aren't related to them. All because we do not know them. Kwa sababu hatuwajui na sio watu wa familia yetu. All because we don't care about God's people. Maybe we have fallen prey into this false saying of every man for himself and God for us all. Brethren, brothers and sisters, we cannot claim that we love God and yet we do not love our neighbors. Hatuwezi sema ya kwamba tunampenda Mungu na hatupendi majirani wetu. Hatupendi watu wa Mungu. Hata kama wanasumbua kiasi gani. Hata kama hawatusiki, bado inafaa tuwapende. 1 John chapter 4 verse 20 says, whoever claims to love God yet hates a brother or sister is a liar. For whoever does not love their brother or sister whom they have seen cannot love God whom they have not seen. If you cannot love your brother and your sister, that neighbor that you see every day, that neighbor that is next door, the next flat, maybe you are that security person that opens the gate for you to your court every day, or even our Masais who are here at the gate. If we do not love them, if we do not acknowledge them, if we do not reach out to them, if we do not express love in action towards them, then we cannot claim that we love God whom we have not seen. Kwa Kiswahili inasema, yeyote anayedai kwamba anampenda Mungu lakini anamchukia ndugu au dada ni muongo. Kwa maana yeyote asiyempenda ndugu yake ambaye amemuona, hawezi kumpenda Mungu ambaye hajamuona. Inatupasa tuwapende majirani zetu ambao tunawaona jinsi ambavyo tunampenda Mungu ambaye hatumuoni. And this reminds me of another song. Today we have many songs. This reminds me of another song by the Gaither Vocal Band. And the song title is, if you don't love your neighbor, then you don't love God. And the first verse, the words are, there are many people who will say they are Christians. And they live like Christians on the Sabbath day, a day like this. But come Monday morning, till the coming Sunday morning, they will fight with their neighbor all along the way. That is the first verse of that song. Kwa Kiswahili inasema, kuna watu wengi ambao watasema wao ni Wakristo. Na wanaishi kama Wakristo siku ya Sabato pekee. Lakini ikifikia Jumatatu asubuhi hadi Jumapili ijayo asubuhi, watapigana na jirani yao njiani. They are just Christians in church but have a bad relationship with their neighbors out there. People they know and people they don't. Maybe you are outgoing in church, but when you get outside the church, people fear you. Because they know, ule mzee, uyo ni waya. Ule mama, ni waya. That is how many believers are. It is so sad to see believers revenging, paying back evil with evil, holding grudges against each other, gossiping, spreading malice, and doing bad things to each other, to the people around them. We need to stop this and let us walk in a manner that is worthy of our calling. Inafaa tuache vitu hivi na tuishi kama Wakristo walioitwa kwa jina la Yesu. Kitabu cha Walawi mlango wa 19 mstari wa 18 inasema, usilipize kisasi au kuwa na kinyongo dhidi ya yeyote kati ya watu wako, bali mpende jirani yako kama nafsi yako. Mimi ndimi Bwana. Leviticus chapter 19 verse 18. Do not seek revenge or bear a grudge against anyone among your people, but love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord. That was a command from the Lord way back in the Old Testament, and it resurfaces back in the New Testament when this lawyer was asking this question: who is your neighbor? Now that we have seen revenging and doing all these things are not good, we need to repent and come back to God. We need to love Him with every aspect of our being and not forgetting loving His people as ourselves, loving our neighbors as ourselves. Let us love one another. Let us express love to one another. Let us love our neighbors in church, in our families, in our workplaces, and our communities at large. The keyword is love. Everyone around us is our neighbor, and we are to love them as ourselves. Kila mtu ambaye ako kando yetu, na kila mtu ambaye ako tunamuona, ni jirani yetu, na tumpende jinsi tunavyojipenda. Tunapaswa kuwapenda walivyo, kwa nguvu zao na kwa upungufu wao. We need to love them. We are supposed to love them as they are. Not just say we love them, but we do not express that love. Don't just love people by words, but love by actions. Tuwapende kwa matendo yetu. Put that love into action. This parable of the Good Samaritan, as we've said, is a window that we also learn from. And we learn two things from the Good Samaritan. Number one, compassionate love. Upendo wa huruma. And number two, sacrificial love. Upendo wa kujitolea. Compassionate love, upendo wa huruma. And sacrificial love, upendo wa kujitolea. Compassionate love. The Samaritan had compassion on that man. Alimuonea huruma. Iyo ndo ilikuwa the first reaction. He had mercy on him and he was moved to his heart. Hence, he helped the man. Jesus Christ also was compassionate to his people. Jesus Christ was compassionate to you and me. And that's why he put this gift of salvation to our disposal. Yesu alituonea huruma na ndiposa akatupea hii wokovu. A compassionate attitude means we will not just choose ourselves, but we'll choose others in their humanity, in their weaknesses, in their sinful nature. We will love them as they are. When we are compassionate, we show mercy to others and help them to our level best, by God's help. God is able to enable us do this for his people. Not by our own strength or ability, but by his grace alone. We first need to accept him to use us. Make that first step, and God will enable you to do it. As believers, we express compassion through forgiving each other, through forgiving those who wrong us, through showing kindness and loving others as ourselves. We express compassion through interacting with the unbelievers out there, through having unbeliever friends, through reaching out intentionally to the unbelievers out there. Sisi kama Wakristo, tunaonyesha hii upendo tukishirikiana na hata wale watu ambao hawajaokoka, kwa sababu pia hao ni majirani wetu na tunajua wako na hitaji, wanahitaji wokovu kutoka kwa Mungu. Ephesians 4:32 says, "Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other just as in Christ God forgave you." Iweni wafadhili, wa Efeso mlango wa 4 mstari wa 32, iweni wafadhili wa na wenye huruma ninyi kwa ninyi, mkasameane kama vile Mungu katika Kristo aliwasamea nyinyi. This act of the Good Samaritan reminds us of God's compassion. Linatukumbusha huruma ya Mungu kwetu. Psalms 86:15 says, "But you, Lord, are a compassionate and gracious God, slow to anger, abounding in love and faithfulness." Zaburi 86 mstari wa 15 inasema, "Lakini wewe, Bwana, u Mungu mwenye huruma na neema, si mwepesi wa hasira, mwingi wa fadhili na uaminifu." This compassion that we see through the Good Samaritan. God showed us compassion and had mercy on us. He saved us from sin and our brokenness through His Son, Jesus Christ. God saved you and me from bondage of sin and death, that we may partake this eternal life through Christ Jesus our Lord. Mungu alituonea huruma, alitupea wingi wa huruma na neema na rehema, na tukapata hii wokovu. Na kupitia hiyo wokovu na kumuamini yeye, tutapata uzima wa milele. Kwa hivyo tunafaa pia kuhurumia wengine. We need to have compassion towards others, towards our neighbors, towards everyone around us. Through the Lord's mercies, we are not consumed, because His compassions fail not. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. That is Lamentations 3:22-23. Kwa rehema za Bwana hatuangami, kwa sababu rehema zake hazikomi. Ni mpya kila asubuhi. Uaminifu wako ni mkuu. Maombolezo 3 mlango 22 hadi 23. This compassion that God lavished on us. This love that He lavished on us. Upendo huu ambayo alitupea kwa wingi, inafaa pia tupee wengine. Na mwezi huu ukiwa mwezi wa kuenda huko uwanjani na kueneza injili ya Bwana Yesu Kristo. This month being the mission month, spreading the gospel personally and corporately, we need to understand this, that we need to love those people as ourselves. We need to show compassion to those people as God showed us compassion. Let us share this compassionate love and show mercy to others, that they may also experience God's saving power through us. Tuonyeshane huruma ndiposa pia watu wengine waweze kupata huu wokovu, nguvu ya wokovu wa Bwana Yesu Kristo. Tushiriki kwa huruma, tushiriki upendo huu wa huruma na kuonyesha wengine rehema hii, ili wapate uzoefu wa nguvu za kuokoa za Mungu kupitia sisi. And our second point, sacrificial love. Upendo wa kujitolea. The Samaritan sacrificed his trip. He canceled his trip. He rescheduled his trip. He sacrificed his time. He sacrificed his wages and other resources for a man he didn't know. Huyu Msamaria alijitolea na alikatiza safari yake, akatumia wakati wake na akatumia vitu vyote alivyokuwa navyo ili aweze kusaidia mtu huyu. He sacrificed for his neighbor. He expressed love to the injured man as though it was himself. And we see that in verse 34 to verse 35. Let us learn to sacrifice for our neighbors, to sacrifice for the people around us, to sacrifice for the people we live with, to sacrifice to the people we meet every day, even in that matatu. Let us put this love into action loving others as ourselves. Tuweze kuweka hiu upendo kwa matendo, tupende wengine jinsi tunavyojipenda. Maybe you might be an answer to someone else's prayer. So let's put love into action. Sacrifice your time, sacrifice your resources. Go out of your way to love your neighbor, to express that love to your neighbor. It can be spreading the gospel to the unbelievers or reaching out to that unbeliever in your neighborhood, reaching out to that unbeliever colleague, reaching out to that unbeliever friend, and being patient with them until that day that they will decide to give their lives to Christ, not giving up on them. It can be sharing the gospel with your co-workers, with your workers, with your colleagues, and even your boss. Inatupasa tuweze kuweka huu pendo kwa matendo na tueneze hata injili kwa wote ambao hawamjui Yesu. Kwa haya yote, kupenda jirani yetu sio rahisi, haitakuwa rahisi. Lakini inatupasa tufanye hivyo. Ndiposa inapaswa tuweze kujitolea. Let's sacrifice to do, so that we can do this command. We can accomplish and obey this command. We are also reminded of Christ's sacrificial love towards us, that while we were still sinners, he died for us. He came to us, bound up our wounds, anointed us with the Holy Spirit, and he walks with us every day as he sanctifies us. Huu upendo wa kujitolea unatukumbusha upendo wa Yesu Kristo kwetu sisi. Kila wakati tunatenda dhambi, kila wakati tunaanguka, lakini anatutakasa kila wakati. Upendo wa kujitolea. In all this, we are called to exercise personal sacrifice for others. Let us learn to go out of our way for others. Hebrews tells us, do not forget to do good and to share with others. For with such sacrifices, God is pleased. Wala msisahau kutenda mema na kushirikiana na wengine. Maana dhabihu na namna hii, za namna hii, Mungu hupendezwa. People around us are facing many challenges and many problems. It is sad that in this digital age, others do not have friends. Mostly among the young people and the teenagers. They do not have friends. They just have digital friends. And because of this, maybe when there is an internet downtime, wakati internet imepotea, someone is disturbed because they don't know any other life apart from that, from life in that device. And so others do not have friends. Wengine hawana marafiki. Many are in depression and have other mental illnesses because they live in a solo world. They live solo in a world full of people. Wengine wanapitia changamoto mingi kwa sababu wanaishi peke yao kwa dunia ambayo imejaa watu wengi. I implore us today, I encourage us today, reach out to that person. Text them or even call them. That person that has come to your mind. Reaching out and going to them is the first step to put that love into action. Kuwaendea ndio jambo la kwanza, kuweka huo upendo kwa matendo. Last Sunday, Pastor Bahati and Mr. Chama shared with us on priestly leadership, Priscilla and Aquila. And we saw how this couple showed hospitality to God's people. And they let them come into their house, into their personal space. Crossing their boundaries and letting them into their lives. And loving our neighbors as ourselves requires this. Kupenda majirani wetu jinsi tunavyojipenda inataka tufanye hivi. Let's do that. Let's open our houses. Let's open our personal spaces for ministry and for others. Let's open them to our neighbors so that we may obey God's command. Love your neighbors as yourselves. Not forgetting that these neighbors sometimes can reject you. Ha majirani wanaweza kukata. Wanaweza leta vita. Others can be very hostile. Can be hostile to your love and everything about you. But you still need to love them. You still need to care for them. You still need to show compassion to them. You still need to sacrifice to them. You still need to love them as yourself. And as we conclude this morning, let us love our neighbors as ourselves, compassionately and sacrificially, as we enter into this mission month. I encourage us today to think about those people whom we don't pay much attention to. Those people that we don't even think about. We know they exist, but we do not think about. Tuweze kufikiria hao watu. Tuweze kufikiria hao watu. Those people might be the support staff in our offices, the cleaners, the tea girls, our security staff, our colleagues, our juniors and our seniors. The people we meet every day, the people around us, whether in need or not in need, we know we can help in a certain way by God's help. Reach out to them, go to them, serve them, share with them what you have. Bring them close to your personal space and care for one another. Love one another. Putting love into action towards those people. With God, all these things are possible. So you don't need to be that Levite or that priest and pass by those who need you, but rather be like that good Samaritan. Kuwa kama huyo Msamaria mwema ambaye alimwendea huyo mtu ambaye alikuwa na hitaji. Reach out to that neighbor that needs your help. Show kindness to them. Be compassionate to them. Love them as you love yourself. Love them as you love yourself. Love them as you love yourself, because that is the second greatest commandment in the law. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you so much, Pastor Vincent. And we've been encouraged. Compassionate love, sacrificial love. And if you look at scripture, everywhere before Jesus will do a miracle, whether it's feeding people, whether it's healing, the Bible says he looked at them and he would have compassion. Compassion pushes us to practical action. Compassion pushes us to doing something, because we live in a broken world. We live in a world where people are suffering, and when we don't reach out, you find so many people, cases of depression have gone up. We're having young people commit suicide. We're having people in marriages kill their spouses. And sometimes it just takes someone to call and find out, how are you doing? And I will not even be surprised if we do a survey here. There are people who don't know their neighbor. If you live in an apartment, you don't even know who lives next door. You have no clue. Maybe the only time you'll knock wale wanatumia tokens is when you need to refill your tokens. If you live in a neighborhood where it's a gated community, probably you only meet maybe when they say there's a joint meeting, or when you're driving past them, just hi, hi. Let's reach out and do something. And this week I was really challenged. There's a documentary I was watching of the loneliest countries in the world. And they were saying that culture is slowly creeping into African countries, where we are becoming so independent. Like, I don't care about what is happening in your life. That is your business. And they were saying, like, when they look in the next 30 years, we might be having the same problems you are seeing in Europe, where people are losing their mind because they have no one to talk to, where people are having to take drugs because of you're struggling from loneliness. People are locking themselves in houses because nobody cares for them. You talk to your family once in a while. You call your sister when there is trouble. Someone has died and we need to do an harambe. So let's break those silos. Let's become like that good Samaritan. Whether someone is in need or not, be a good neighbor. Amen? Yes, let's stand up. And as we sing this song, the media team will request you to just put the lyrics. And we can sing it, especially the last stanzas of the song, where we are called out by faith. Our faith is an action faith. Is action-based faith. And by faith we will do these things. By faith we will reach out to other people.
By faith we see the hand of God in the light of creation's grand design, to the lives of those who prove his faithfulness. We walk by faith and not by sight. By a faith our Father strong the young, with the power of his promise in their heart, of a holy city built by God's own hand, a place where peace and justice reign. We will stand as children of the promise. We will fix our eyes on
the children of the promise. And
Lord, today we have been challenged to go out there and love others. Today we have been challenged that, Lord, we need to have compassion on others. We need to love others sacrificially, oh God. The Lord, we will sacrifice our time, we will sacrifice our spaces, we will sacrifice our resources, oh God, to ensure that other people experience your love. And Lord, I pray that you will use us, oh God, as even part of the, Lord, part of the remedy to fix this broken world. That our love will be used to fix families, oh God, broken homes, broken children. Lord, that Lord, you will use our voices, you will use our resources, oh God, to show love to others, oh God. The Lord Jesus, we will be concerned about our neighbors, neighbors in our families, neighbors in our where we live, oh God, and even beyond. The Lord, that love will spread from us, oh God. That we will become like that yeast that is able to influence others into the love of Christ. So Lord, we surrender to you, oh God. And may you use us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Pastor Vincent. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord refresh you for bringing his word to us. And just an encouragement, today we are selling mandazis before we close the service. So the mandazis are out there. Please buy, because you'll be supporting the Grow and Grow fundraiser. So, and also this ministry of hospitality. They've given themselves to come early and make those mandazis. So kindly, if you have some money left, buy some mandazis and support this ministry. Then also a reminder, remember to just go into the office, pick a package of mboga for every home. They're enough for all of us. So if you leave your package, we will have excess. And we want all of you to be part of this blessing. So turn to someone as you share in the words of grace and shake their hands, smile at them, show some love. Yes, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen, amen, amen. Have a blessed week ahead.
We will stand as children of the poor.